Good morning and morning. Welcome back to our vlog. This is day 5 of Vlogmas. We look like such tools right now, Ryan, but you know, we're playing the role of Santa's elves today, and it's very exciting. We are dropping off just moonshine at some of our friends, and with our Christmas card, the moonshine that Ryan made.
So far, everyone's liked it.
Yeah. So just my parents, we had to take a Christmas card photo of them plus Rhoda. And now we're off. I think we have 6 houses to drop these off at. Mm-hmm. And yeah, we even got we have some Santa hats. We're just really playing the part today.
We're doing it. We're being a little extra.
It's actually quite a holiday day we have planned ahead, so be very excited about that. Just got home from delivering and I accidentally ordered, we are getting pizza and wings, and I ordered it to a location that is like 40 minutes away from us, and so I had to cancel it and then reorder it, so it didn't like line up timing wise for us to both go. So I'm going to pick up pizza at this place called Garbanzo's. We haven't ate at this place since high school, but I mean, it's a good spot. It's been there for years now, but we were like, we should support a local business and get some pizza and wings for game day. Plus, Ryan and I are going to try some holiday beers. I'll show you guys what we get, and then we're gonna do that shortly, probably before the Packer game, get some beers in us. Let's check out this pizza. All right, that looks delicious. Mm-hmm. Yum, yum, yum. Hey guys, we're gonna do another little taste testing thing because we enjoyed it too much last time when we did the Bud Light ones, and now we're gonna test out different holiday beers that we could find locally.
Yeah, just some random ones that were at the store.
And yeah, we have actually, we're gonna give like a little shout out to our friends at the Boise Binge. It's our friends Lexi and Brayden. Lexi's actually one of my bridesmaids at my wedding, and her boyfriend sample out different local beers and then talk about also like different like local things that they enjoy, like
food spots, bars, stuff
brands,
like that.
Yeah, like they just talked about like some of like the best late night food in downtown Boise, and I'll attach like their YouTube channel down below if you're interested in that. It's really fun to watch, especially if you're local, because you just get to like see places that like you're familiar with and like see their opinions on it, and yeah, it's very fun.
We'll start with, oh, this sounds light. A New Belgium Accumulation. I just found it at the store. It's a white IPA from New Belgium out of Fort Collins, Colorado.
I'm not a big IPA person, so some of these will be kind of interesting, but I'm very open. I'm open to trying really any type of beer. Ryan is, you pretty much like everything.
For the most part. Cheers, here we go. That
was terrible. I did that so weird.
I like that.
Yeah. I don't like love IPAs.
It's not like super hoppy though.
It's not super hoppy. I would say it's like kind of almost tastes flat to me.
Oh really?
Yeah. But it's like not bad. Got a bowl to dump in case we don't want to finish any of these. I mean, I don't think it's bad. I just wouldn't normally drink it.
I mean, it's fine. I wouldn't say it's like anything crazy. It doesn't make me think it's a winter beer.
I was just gonna say I don't drink this and think winter. I just think IPA. Okay, so I'm gonna rate the New Belgium beer like a 6.
Yeah, I was gonna give it like a 6.5. Okay, is what I'd give it.
There we go.
It's not anything crazy. Should we just keep the IPA train rolling?
Let's mix it up. How many IPAs do we have?
2.
Okay.
But the next one, the other IPA is a double.
Yeah, let's maybe not do 2 IPAs in a row.
The Breckenridge Christmas Ale. A malty, full-bodied winter warmer.
Perfect.
I was really wanting
that
to try
that. Sounds good.
I was really wanting to try this last year, but I couldn't find it anywhere.
Well, and we like Breckenridge Brewery. Mm-hmm. We actually have been there. When we went to Colorado this summer, we went and stopped at this brewery. Okay. Oh. I enjoy that.
It's sweet.
I like it.
Yeah, it's good. It's sweet. Is it?
Let me see, what are, like, do they have notes on there or anything?
Because it's a winter warmer. I didn't know if that meant more alcohol, which it's 7.1.
That's a good amount.
Yeah, that's a little higher, good. I'd say.
Flavors of caramel and chocolate derived from abundance of carefully roasted malts. Okay, that kind of makes sense. I actually like this.
I got a lot of caramel.
I was gonna say very caramely to me. You good?
Yeah, it's bourbon.
I really like this one.
Yeah, it's tasty.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna give this one an 8. I like it.
7.7.
There you go.
Okay, let's not totally wreck our palates quite yet. Sun King Brewery, it's called the Electric Reindeer.
Where's Sun King Brewery from? Indianapolis.
Indianapolis.
Wow.
It is a brown ale brewed with ginger and molasses, so it's probably going to be... You're not a big brown ale fan.
Mm-mm. But a ginger and molasses sounds kind of good, though, too.
It's a pretty cool can.
Okay. 5.5 is the ABV.
Oh, that's low.
Yeah, it's not bad. Moderately sweet, lightly bitter, with a subtle lingering sweetness. Okay, with aromas of ginger, cinnamon, clove, nutmeg, allspice, molasses, brown sugar, caramel, and vanilla. Okay, so it sounds like it's gonna be sweet.
Yeah, I'm excited for this one.
I think I could maybe do like a sweet brown.
Yeah.
I'm just not normally like a big brown ale person.
Well, it smells like a ginger snap.
Ooh, yeah, wow. Ooh.
It looks like...
It looked like thick when you poured it. Wow, that's really sweet.
Yeah, it's good.
I would not say it is moderately sweet, the way they say it on the site. That is a sweet beer.
Yeah, that's
it's
really
good.
Sweet.
The flavor's really good.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that's so sweet.
Yeah, it's good. I like it.
I don't think I could have more than one. Like
I don't even know if I could have a whole can of it. That's good.
It is good.
It's a good beer. What would you rate it?
Probably like a 7.5.
I'm going to say 8.2.
8.2, okay.
I think it's good.
What do you think next? I know what one I'm gonna try next.
The sour?
Uh-huh.
This looks like a ugly sweater can.
Mm-hmm.
But it is from Prairie Artisan Ales. It is called Seasick Crocodile. It's a sour, and it's their sour ale with cranberries, ginger, cinnamon, and nutmeg. Oh. 6.3%. Yeah, I haven't seen like a ton of like winter sours, I feel like.
Never. When I like love sours, I feel like in the last couple years, maybe a year and a half or so, I've discovered that sours are like some of my favorite beers.
I'm not the biggest fan of them. There are certain ones that I do like.
Sours are just pretty too. They're normally like almost like a little pinky color or orange. Ooh, wow. Okay, wait, what's the notes again? Cranberries, ginger.
Cinnamon and nutmeg.
Okay, I can really smell the cinnamon and the ginger.
Oh, yeah. It's probably just gonna really taste like cranberries and ginger.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, I'm excited.
Let's give it a go. Whoa. It's a lot of nutmeg.
That. Wow.
It's sour.
Yeah, it's really sour. Where is Prairie Artisan Ales out of?
Brewed and canned in McAlester, Oklahoma.
In Oklahoma.
That's what it says.
I love that drink. Like, that beer is so good. For me, I would literally rate that a 10. But like, also, like, that's like my type of beer that I really like. So I feel like if you don't like sours, it's pretty sour. But I also think it'd be, I feel like people that don't like sours might like that.
Yeah, I would rate it 8.4.
Ooh.
Just on a general beer scale.
Yeah. I love it.
It's good. It's not too heavy. So we got a Full Sail Brewing double IPA called Wreck the Halls.
Where's Full Sail out of?
It's out of Oregon. Where in Oregon is it out of? Hood River, Oregon. A very low 8.5%.
I want to be optimistic about this one, but like I just really have never tasted a double IPA that I like.
This is gonna be hefty.
Yeah, not because it's like a bad beer or anything, but I just normally don't prefer the taste of IPAs, and double IPAs are obviously
double
the fun. Smells like a double IPA.
Smells pretty hoppy.
Smells pretty hoppy, okay.
Cheers.
I love the can though.
Yeah, the can's cool.
Oh my god. I do not like that.
You don't have to finish that one.
I'm going to try again.
It's heavy. It's a heavy beer. I have to have like salty snacks with it.
I feel like that like immediately like took all my taste buds away. Mm-hmm. Like my palate's gone.
I have some nuts.
I know. I'm going to finish it though.
Ugh. I mean, I don't think it's anything special. I don't even know if I would say it's a winter beer. It's just their winter double IPA. Mm. 6.8.
4. Maybe even 3. I don't like that at all. Like, but like, I'm sure it's a good beer if you like stuff like that. I'm just not.
I mean, it's a good IPA. I just don't think there's nothing special about it. We got one more. We picked this up at the Rogue Brew House when we were in Portland. And it is their 2020 Santa's Private Reserve. It's a peppermint bark milk stout. 8.3%. It says that this is mostly chocolatey, malty, and sweet. It says to pair it with deviled eggs.
I just saw it in pot roast or pork roast?
Pork roast and sugar cookies.
Huh.
I can see the sugar cookies, but the deviled eggs.
Deviled eggs, I don't know about that. Keep in mind, we could be eating deviled eggs with this. Maybe that's what we should think about when we taste it. I like this.
It's a cool bottle.
The bottle is very cool.
It smells very chocolatey. Mm-hmm. It looks like melted chocolate. Whoa.
Wow. That's sweet.
It's really chocolatey. Like I can hardly taste the peppermint.
Yeah, it's super chocolatey. It's good though.
I wouldn't want it with deviled eggs.
Hell no. It's not super pepperminty, which I mean, the whole branding's around candy canes.
Yeah, I think it would be better if it was a little more pepperminty. Like it's mostly just chocolate.
I also think it'd be better if they just called it, peppermint barks. Actually, I could consider this like a peppermint bark actually, because like peppermint bark isn't like super heavy on, well, in like the overwhelming flavor of peppermint. It's really more chocolatey, yeah.
I guess I was just thinking peppermint beer, not peppermint bark.
Okay, then maybe they're actually right on the mark.
It's pretty spot on. There's just so many damn candy canes on. Like, it's literally Santa chopping down a candy cane with an axe.
So, yeah, maybe they actually hit the mark, but I was just maybe confused of like the drawing, but not reading it. That's pretty accurate.
Makes more sense.
Mm-hmm. Probably rate it like an 8.
I was gonna give it a 7.8.
Overall, I liked the sour one the most.
I think I like the electric reindeer the most.
Mm-hmm. That one's good. Thank you so much for tuning in to that little portion of the vlog. We're going to be vlogging the rest of the day too, so we'll just pick up the rest of the day.
Well, guys, you were talking about Aaron Rodgers and Davante Adams' unique connection. Much like Rodgers, Adams,
gotcha.
And Jordy Nelson, in the 7 years they were together, this is Adam communication, and it's led to this.
So the night is young, everyone. This has been like a long day.
Yeah.
Don't you agree? Yeah. It's 7:15 and we actually just were watching the day 4 Vlogmas because I finished it. But Ryan is going to put in the family stone and I am going to pick a bottle for us.
Packers won. Big day.
We're going to do this bottle of wine. I actually really like this brand. We got our nice new glasses of wine. Honestly, these are... Ooh, they just sound so good.
That
clinkety tinkety. How do you open this guy?
That's just a twist.
Just a twist? For who? For strong people? Oh, I got it. Ooh,
yeah, for strong people.
I am the strongest woman in all life. Holiday hack. Get yourself one of these. Helps you pour the wine better. It's actually so much easier. I thought it was just like one of those like novelty things that like you put on wine to like look cool. And then I realized it actually is very helpful.
Pirating is just like stealing.
I'm getting good at like making them like exact.
Cheers.
Dinner is just leftovers tonight. We didn't make it to the store. I'm gonna go tomorrow. This sounds delightful. And we're watching, the Family Stone. The character Amy, that's Rachel McAdams, is very similar to me.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's fun.
If it looks like I've been crying, it's because I have been. We just watched The Family Stone, and that one just gets me. I just can't. I think I cried 3 times during that. Well, happy Sunday.
We made it through.
Yep, we're going to end the vlog here. I hope you guys enjoyed day 5 of Vlogmas. So yeah, make sure that you like and subscribe if you enjoyed this one, and we'll see you guys next time.
See ya.
Dodger, do you want to say goodbye to the vlog? Say goodbye. Bye, vlog. Here's your warning again. If you are sensitive to burps, I'd exit out right now. In 3, 2, 1.
Okay. Jesus.
Sorry. It just came on. Like, third beer in, and I'm like, I can feel the burps coming.